I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company, and I am here today with our interactive production manager, Joel Kohlander. Amongst your other responsibilities from managing our social media, you also, Joel's the author of a lot of our blogs, so a lot of you are familiar with Joel's work. He's done some videos, but we're happy to have you here, Joel.
Thank you, it's good to be here.
We're here today to talk to you about our upcoming May 5th, 6th, and 7th Premiere Firearms Auction. And Joel, you know it as good as I do. We had an absolutely awesome year in 2016.
Yeah, industry records broken in 2017's. Starting the same way.
We're starting right where we left off, ladies and gentlemen. In terms of condition, in terms of rarity, in terms of genres, we have some 17th century stuff. Move all the way forward. We have over 100 Class 3 items in this sale. Whether it's Colts, Winchesters, U.S. military, high-end sporting arms, we have something for you in this upcoming sale. And the one I left out was European or German military. And that's what we're here to talk about today. I should emphasize that this is really the tip of the spear in terms of what we have in terms of World War I, World War II, and pre-war European guns. So this is the tip of the spear. This is the best of the best to represent it. And, you know, we'll just dive right in and we'll talk about them. So I'm going to start here, Joel. We'll kind of pass it around. We're not going to go in any order. But we just want to show you some cool stuff, some high condition stuff, some one of ones. We'll start right here. You know, we had the Robert Brotherton collection in 2016. A lot of European guns, obviously. He had a number of Bergmans. This is not from the Robert Brotherton collection, but Bergmans drew great interest in 2016. We imagine they'll do the same thing in 2017. We have a 1897 number 5 Bergman. You'll notice the condition. And then what also sets it apart is the equally rare combination holster and the shoulder stock, but a rare piece worthy of any European military collection. I'll jump back here and then we can kind of talk about how all these three pieces come together. So we've sold a number of the Luftwaffe drillings issued to the AFRICORPS. These were their survival rifles. And we talk about German manufacturing, German engineering. It's obvious when you look at this stuff. But this is what, you know, this is what they issued for a survival rifle for their down pilots. And you just look at the work, you look at the quality. It has its case. Really neat. I mean, you can't make half this stuff up. This is as good as it gets in terms of condition. Joel, let's jump to the, 900-pound elephant in the room?
Indeed. We have another, the third in recent memory, FG-42. And that's not to say they're common by any means.
No.
With the results we're getting, with these at auction, they're coming out of the woodwork.
When it rains, it pours. We set a world record, the first one we had several years back. We set a world record at 299,000. And then we were had the opportunity to sell another one, which beat it, not by a lot, but it also broke that record. So, and as far as I know, that's the highest price for a machine gun at auction. So Rock Island Auction holds that record. We're proud. We're happy to have this as a second model gun with the bayonet. We have a scope in the auction. It's not accompanying the gun itself, but it is separate. So if you want to put the whole package together, you have that opportunity. And so you have made by Krieghoff and issued to the paratroopers. So also, how do these things come together? Well, here we have one of many pieces from the Putnam Green Sycamore collection in the sale, a World War II paratrooper's helmet, Folsom Jaeger, with the chicken wire. This is with the chicken wire, single decal. The Putnam Green Sycamore collection represents the finest collection of its type ever put together.
We love when their pieces come through. Not only are they the condition, it's authentic.
Absolutely.
100%.
Which is hard to find these days. I mean, you'll see 9 out of 10 pieces not be correct.
Yeah.
They might be parts of originals, but when you look at Putnam Green Sycamore stuff, you know you're looking at the real deal. We guarantee that 100%, and then we write that in our catalogs. So let's talk about some Lugers here, Joel.
I think a pistol everybody's a big fan of is a Russian contract Luger, pretty easily identifiable with the Cyrillic text back here by the safety. And if we look on the top band, a pair of crossed Mosin Nagant rifles. Pretty identifiable, pretty rare, very collectible.
Very rare. Again, when it rains, it pours. You don't see this stuff every day. I always say when you make something rare look common, you're not doing your job. But these things, you know, you could spend years, decades, trying to find one to put in your collection. Here's the opportunity.
And right behind it, perhaps even more rare, a Luger, a Mexican contract Luger with the Spanish text on the side.
One of two known. Here's your shot, ladies and gentlemen. Here's your shot. It's not only rare, it's equally magnificent. It's a beautiful gun, high condition gun. Truly two exceptional Lugers, two extremely rare Lugers. Let's jump to another gun that we're recently familiar with, that Sauer 38H, Joel.
Correct. Having sold one in recent memory, and perhaps maybe all of memory that I have, a Sauer that's a Heinrich Himmler presentation pistol. On the side it says Dem Scharfschützen, which is for the sharpshooter. And Himmler had, in kind of an interesting propaganda meeting, the military gave them away as almost prizes for accomplished shooters. That was something for 100 kills?
Sure, yeah, it's an identified gun. You'll see it in a number of different books. Not this gun specifically, but they talk about this model. They're really rare presentations mm-hmm. for sniper kills, predominantly on the Eastern Front, but we're happy to have another one, happy to offer another one to the collecting community. Let's talk about that Walther.
Let's do it. NSKK Walther with its holster, also stamped, and just the condition on it. I'm surprised there aren't like lights gleaming back to the cameras from that thing. It is gorgeous.
Rarity and condition combined in that piece. If you're looking for one that would be impossible to improve upon, that's it. Transitioning, we'll talk about this Cone Hammer Mauser. We've sold this gun actually twice. It's the second time we've had this piece up for sale. We sold it about 8 years ago, and then we sold it about 3 years ago, and lucky for you, it's back again. 1896 broom handle, cone hammer gun, but that's rare and that's desirable. What makes this gun special is the Porfirio Diaz. It was presented to Mexican President Porfirio Diaz, factory gold inlaid, factory engraved. It has a wonderful presentation case with the stock, full complement of accessories, a really great piece of history, a really high condition rare thing.
It's an absolutely gorgeous piece. To have the gold initials on there, it just jumps off the table, not to mention all the niter blue.
That's a perfect combination of history and condition. And lastly, I had to finish with this piece when we're talking about condition. We're talking about rarity. Walther, synonymous with German manufacturing for firearms. We talk about guns, again, we talk about 95%, 96%. And as studied collectors know, that you pay for the extra 2 or 3% of condition that exists. You're looking at a 99% gun. Not only is it a 99% gun, but it is phenomenal.
It's art.
It is absolutely 100% all there. It's a 1926 model, which has a rich and storied history. But this gun is, it's semi-relief engraved. There's a lot of metal taken out of there. And the art and the way and the form in which it's done, you see why a lot of the iconic 19th century American engravers immigrated from Germany, and you see the craftsmanship, it's something you have to behold. Joel and I are both in awe of it standing here,
yeah.
But you got to put it in your hand
and seeing the different little, I don't want to call them panel scenes, but you have the goddess of the hunt included in the floral and vine engraving on the top. You have a target bullseye with holes in the target engraved on the front strap there. It's an incredible piece. How it's not in a museum is beyond me.
Well, and luckily it's not, and that's your opportunity. There's your shot. That's what makes us great. That's what makes this hobby so fun, is that you can own this stuff. These are treasures in world history. The artwork that, this gun represents, for what other hard asset collectibles will bring. That is as much artwork that you'll see in a Picasso or a Renoir. That is as good as it gets. And ladies and gentlemen, this is just the beginning. From, again, European, German military guns, U.S. military guns, Winchesters, Colts, high-end sporting guns. This sale is something that you're going to want to be a part of. You're going to want to come see this stuff for yourself. Mark it in your calendars. May 5th, 6th, and 7th. Rock Island Auction Company's first premier auction of 2017. Do not forget the preview day. That's your opportunity to see this stuff, hold this stuff. We make it fun too. So when you come for a preview, we do a full day preview, and then we have a party. We have food, cold beer, cold drinks, live music. It's a blast. I couldn't encourage you enough. We hope to see you in May.